Okay, I'm going to show you on this project a little bit of what understanding just a tiny bit about your values can help you do beautiful backgrounds. Okay, so we've got this red, and just tore my hair out with my glasses. That was fun. Okay, I'm going to cut this off. This is on the Gray Matters palette paper. And I'll go ahead and cut this even so that I get an unbroken line on my red. So what you're going to do is you're going to look at your red and look at the colors of gray. You're going to squint your eyes, okay? And I think it's disappearing. Like the bridge between the two is disappearing here at an 8. So this is actually just 2 steps away from the darkest color, okay, which is black. So we're way, way up here. Now, if I have the color white, I am way, way, way down here at white, okay? And then if I have the color bleach sand, I'm probably at a 4. And then if I have khaki tan, I'm probably at a 6-7, somewhere in there. Okay, now these are all, in this particular palette, I'm calling these my whites. Okay, but this is, if you isolate it by itself, is in no way a white. It is, you know, a brown or a tan. So, but what's neat about this, because these are the white families, if you will, I can make my snowflakes be snowflakes, but make them be part of my background. So let me show you what the difference is. I'm going to do a little bit with the khaki tan. I go a little bit with bleach sand. And a little bit with white. I think my white might need to be shaken up. Okay, so we're going to take a stencil. Let's go ahead and just do a little stencil. Move some of these colors. And we'll put that little stencil in here. I'm using a crescent brush. And we'll start with our dark color. That's our khaki. I'm going to wipe it off. Now, this is part of this dreamy technique that I've discovered this year. Instead of stippling, which is going to make a very clean, crisp outline, I'm going to scumble. And the scumbling is, I've wiped most of my paint off here. The scumbling is going to create this kind of dreamy looking little snowflake. Okay, so we can see I've got a little snowflake. Now, let's take that same snowflake and let's go into bleach sand. I'm going to neutralize the color, so I'll go into it and then I'll go one more time because it'll be too much a mix of the two colors. So I'm just going to go ahead and put a bleach sand snowflake there. Okay. Now see what happens? See how bright that is? Okay, it's not wrong, but it's getting kind of like where it's commanding attention from my lettering. So if you're commanding attention from the lettering, it's going to be kind of, I guess, more noisy, if you will. Okay, now I'll go into white. I'll neutralize that. I know you can already tell what's going to happen. Okay, now I go there. Now look what's happened. Now this looks like it's almost disappeared. This is like, hey, who cares? And now this is taking over everything. And because it's such a solid color, it's really competing with that. So I would always want to do something a little bit more tone on tone. So with, I'll just go ahead and squirt a little bit of water there, and we'll just wipe these off, or at least back them down. There's a really cool little trick you can do with an eraser. You can dip your white erasers in water when paint is still fresh, and it'll actually erase the fresh paint. Okay. So that's gone. Now, if I wanted to make stencils, like if I wanted to have layers of stencils, let me get another example here. Okay, this is the Four Season Wreath. Totally different color scheme, so we'll move this guy. But notice what I have going on here. I've got some dark, darker blue, and then I start popping up with a lighter blue, with a lighter color. I could take my whites if I wanted to really have them competing, and I could go right on board with just strong white. This technique of wiping off on the paper towel is really important too. So if I wanted to create a third layer, now I can have that be that third brighter layer, and that's going to give me more depth and more depth and more depth. Okay, so you can decide how much depth you want by just scumbling on your different values for your stencils. Okay, these three designs, let's get you closer here. These these three designs, and you can't really even see what's going on with this one, so I'll bring him forward. These are examples of what background word stencils can do for you. Okay, and we've got kitchen ones and wine ones, and these are inspirational ones and Frankenstein ones and snow ones and kitchen and all the things. So, but if you treat these exactly like what I just showed you with the snowflake stencil and you use your values, then you can create something that's so subtle you almost can't tell that it's there, and it just looks really, really relaxed, and it just adds a little bit of depth. Or you can make it be like shazowie. Here's what I'm trying to do. But still, I kept my values kind of controlled, so the words aren't taking over. I didn't do them in black or white or anything like that. I just did it in a tone-on-tone. And then I did the same thing with this. So we've got, and then I did also the same thing with my snowflakes. Here's a really reduced value one, and here's one that is much stronger. And all of these things were done using the crescent brushes, which aren't new, or the dome brushes. Both of them are awesome. If I want to get this big kind of tracking magical dust, then I'm going to start with just dry rubbing and building, and then I will build to another color within the trail. Okay, and then I use, this one is a little bit of a desert turquoise kind of color, just to give it some contrast. But this this technique, using these brushes with any kind of stencil, is just a really neat way to get that awesome depth in your backgrounds.